Hey there, it's Kaylee. In this lesson, we will learn how to find the area of parallelograms and trapezoids. Let's get started. Do you remember how to find the area of a rectangle? We can use a formula that says the area is equal to the length times the height. On this rectangle, the length is 6 and the height is 2. So we would multiply those together to get 12. Now what about finding the area of a parallelogram? Notice that the parallelogram is similar, but because the sides are angled, we can't use the same formula and multiply side length as the height. We need to know the actual height of the parallelogram. Since we have a grid, we can count the height by counting the squares, 1, 2. And we see the length is labeled as 5, but I only count 1, 2, 3, 4 whole squares. But notice that these partial squares over here and these ones over here make up a full square. So in fact, I do have 5 square lengths. So now we can multiply length times height. 5 times 2 is 10. Are you curious about how we can use the same formula for a parallelogram and a rectangle or a square? Well, imagine this. You have a square with a height of 10 and a length or a width that's also of 10. And that gives you, when you multiply them together, an area of 100. Now, if you have a parallelogram that also has a length or a width down here of 10, and it tells you that the height here is 10, but you're not sure how long this side length is, you know that that's okay because the formula is the same. You multiply the width or the length down here times the height. And to see how that would be true, we can drag the corner from our parallelogram over here. And if we drag it over and put it over here, we see that we have the same shape as this 10 by 10 square. So that's how a parallelogram and a rectangle can share the same formula for area. So let's find the area of this parallelogram using our formula, area equals base times height. So I know my base is this distance down here, measuring at 7 feet, and I see that my height is this measurement here. Notice it's not the same as my side length, and it is 3 feet. So I can say area is equal to 7 feet, my base, times 3 feet, my height, and that will give me 21. I have to square my unit, square feet. And there we have it. Now that we know how to find the area of rectangles and parallelograms, let's look at trapezoids. Now looking at these three shapes, can you think of a way that we can compose or manipulate the trapezoid to calculate its area? So here I have one trapezoid, and you can see the different dimensions. I have my top up here, my bottom down here, and the height of my trapezoid. Now watch as I compose the trapezoid into another shape. So I'm taking now two trapezoids. I'm going to rotate one of them, and when I put it together, I've composed a parallelogram. So now I have a parallelogram, and I know how to find the area of a parallelogram. It's A is equal to base times height. And here I know my height already is 7, but what's my base? It's this line here plus this line here. But I know what the distance is here because it's the top from my purple trapezoid. So that's a 6. So if I wanted to find the area of this parallelogram, I would have my base would be the base of 1, this up here, plus the base of 2, this one down here, and I have to multiply all of that by my height. And that would give me the area of this entire parallelogram. But now what if I only want the area for one trapezoid? Well, one trapezoid is half the area of my parallelogram, right? Because this is made up of two trapezoids. So I take this area that I've just created for this parallelogram, where I add my two bases together, and I would divide it by 2. So now I'd have area is equal to b1 plus b2 times the height all over 2. Now let's find the area for this trapezoid using the formula we derived that says area is equal to base 1 plus base 2 times the height all over 2. So we can see here that we have two bases, one down here measuring at 6 inches and one up here measuring at 2 inches. And then we have our height right here coming in at our right ankle. All right, so we can say area is equal to 6 inches plus 2 inches all times 4 inches divided by 2. So we do our order of operations, parentheses go first, 6 inches plus 2 inches, that gives me 8 inches. 8 inches times 4 inches all over 2. So now I have 8 inches times 4 inches. 8 times 4 gives me 32. I have to multiply my units together, so that means gives me inches squared or square inches all over 2. And now 32 divided by 2, that gives us 16 square inches as our area. Great job! Now you know the formulas for finding area in parallelograms and trapezoids. Practice what you've learned by doing the online games and quizzes. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.